Hello, friends. This is Brian from This Fantastic Life. In today's episode, we're going to take you to Fort Indian Town Gap National Cemetery for the annual laying of the wreaths by Wreaths Across America. In 1992, Merle Worcester, owner of Worcester Wreath Company, had a surplus of wreaths at the end of the holiday season. Remembering a childhood trip to Arlington National Cemetery, he arranged to have the excess wreaths laid to some graves there. The tradition continued until it received national attention on the internet. In 2007, the Worcester family formed the nonprofit Wreaths Across America to continue this effort at national cemeteries across the United States, with the goal to remember, honor, and teach. Having several relatives that are interred at Fort Indian Town Gap National Cemetery, we traveled there for the first time to join Wreaths Across America and thousands of other volunteers on December 17th, 2022. The volunteers spread out throughout the cemetery and one by one laid a wreath at each tombstone, saying the name of the individual and saying a little prayer as well. The ceremony began with the Rolling Thunder Motorcycle Wreath Escort, a bagpipe escort to America, and the riderless horse.
The mission began 25 years ago with 5,000 wreaths placed at Arlington. Today, there are over 2.5 million wreaths placed in 3,600 participating locations where our veterans are laid to rest. We are all proud Americans that live in a free society made up of many people from many walks of life. The freedoms we enjoy have not come without a price. Lying here before us, in this cemetery and throughout the nation, are men and women who gave their lives so that we can have freedom without fear. As we honor the fallen today, we also honor the men and women that are presently serving in our military. We honor them and their families for their sacrifice that they make day to day to keep our country safe.
Following the presentation of the colors, there was an invocation, and then the national anthem.
Can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Flyover was coordinated by Tim Trimble. And they just keep coming.
Lots of different pairs of aircraft.
John Jernigan.
With us today are Gold Star family members. The Lamarne family honoring Specialist Brian Lamarne Veldman. The Steech family honoring Sergeant Dennis Steech. The Seitz family honoring Staff Sergeant Keith Bishop. The Bortz family honoring Chief Warrant Officer 4 Joseph Bortz. The Yoder family, honoring Chief Warrant Officer 2, Jarrett Yoder. The McKesky family, honoring Private First Class Joshua McKesky. The Ruffner family, honoring Chief Warrant Officer 3, Matthew Ruffner. The Small family, honoring Sergeant Mark Small. The Evans family, honoring Specialist William Billy Evans.
Placing the United States Marine Corps Veterans Wreath is Fleet Marine Force Corpsman John Pichar.
With us today are Gold Star family members. The Zuni family, honoring Lance Corporal Joseph Zuni.
Placing the United States Navy Veterans Wreath is RCI William Verodi.
With us today are Gold Star family members, the Stavitsky and the Harvey families, honoring Aviation Machinist Mate Airman Apprentice Jeffrey Harvey.
Placing the United States Air Force Veterans Wreath is United States Air Force Academy Cadet Christopher Adam in tribute to his grandfather.
With us today are Gold Star family members, the Travilla family, honoring Captain Michael Travilla.
Placing the United States Space Force Veterans Wreath is Senior Master Sergeant John Killinger, Jr. The United States Coast Guard Veterans Wreath is Master Chief Paul Landry. Placing the United States Public Health Service Commissioned Corps and the National Oceanographic and Atmospheric Commissioned Officer Corps wreath is Sergeant First Class Carissa Fave. Placing the United States Merchant Marine Veterans Wreath is Radioman First Class Floyd Turner. Placing the Prisoner of War or Missing in Action Veterans Wreath is Specialist 5, Barry Jacobs. These ceremonial wreaths and all the wreaths you'll be placing today signify our commitment to remember and honor all of America's veterans.
If you like this video, please click like and be sure to subscribe to our channel for more content. Click that little icon in the lower right-hand corner of your screen. And also, if you'd like more information about Wreaths Across America, please see the link in the comments. Thank you for watching.